Nucleus is microkernel of Spring, and it is a subset of lead case prescription, as I mentioned just now, in the sense that Nucleus manages only threads and IPC. The abstractions available in Nucleus are the following. There is this domain. A domain is similar to Unix process. It's a container or an address space, and threads can execute in a particular domain. These threads are similar in semantics to pthread that we have seen before. And this abstraction called door is a software capability to a domain. It's you can think of it as this real-life analogy of opening a door in order to get into a room. In a similar manner, if you have a handle to the door, you can open the door and enter a target domain. So that's the idea behind door. So any domain can create these Nucleus entities called doors, which are essentially entry points for entering the target domain. With the object orientation, I told you that the only thing that you can do is make invocations on objects, and the entry points available in the objects that are contained in a domain are represented by this abstraction called door that's provided by Nucleus. Let's say I'm a file server. What will I do? Well, I have entry points in my file server, such as opening a file or reading a file, writing a file, and so on. Basically, I will create those entry points as doors into my domain. And now if I'm a client, how do I get access to the entry points that's available in a target domain? Well, the way I do that is exactly similar to how you may be opening a file in a Unix file system. What you do is an fopen, and when you do that, you get a file descriptor, which is a small integer that is a handle for you to access that file. In a similar manner, if I'm a client and if I want the ability to invoke a target domain, a particular entry point, then what I want is an access to this door. And the way I get that is by getting a door handle. So I get a door handle. So every domain will have this door table, which is similar to the file descriptors that you may have in a Unix process. And every door ID that you have in this door table points to a particular door. If I have a door handle in my door table for a particular door, what that tells me is that, oh, I have the ability to make an invocation in the target domain that this particular door corresponds to. So the possessor of a door handle is able to make object invocations on the target domain using this door handle. And as you can see, a particular client domain can have a door table that has access to several different target domains. So in this case, these two entries in my door table points to this door, which probably are entry points into this target domain, another door, which are a different set of entry points, and I have access to them as well. And multiple clients may have access to the same door, because if it's a file system, for instance, you may be able to access the file system, I may be able to access the file system, and so on. So the door table is something that is unique to every domain, and it gives that domain an ability to access the entry points in the target domain so that they can make object invocations. So the way to think about this door, it's basically a software capability to a domain. Since we are using object orientation, it is represented by a pointer to a C++ object that represents the target domain. And door can be passed from domain to domain. It's a software capability, and it can be passed from domain to domain. And when it is passed from domain to domain, it gives the ability for those domains to actually get access to the entry points specified through this door to the target domain. And the Spring kernel itself is a composition of the Nucleus plus the memory management that is inherent in the fact that these domains represent an address space. Now, how do you go about making an object invocation? That is, you want to make a protected procedure call into a target domain from a client domain. How do I do that? Well, the Nucleus is involved in every door call. So I want to open the door, I need the permission of the Nucleus. And what I do is when I make the invocation using the small descriptor that I have, which is the door handle, the Nucleus looks at it, says, okay, this domain has the ability to do this invocation, and it allocates a server thread in the target domain and executes the invocation that is indicated by this particular door handle. It's a protected procedure call, and since it is procedure call semantics, the client thread is deactivated and the thread is allocated to the target domain so that it can execute the invocation for the method that is indicated by this door handle. And on return from this target domain, once that protected procedure call is complete, the thread is deactivated and the client thread is reactivated so that the client can continue with whatever it was doing before. So this is very, very similar to the communication mechanism that we discussed in the lightweight remote RPC paper before, in the sense that we are doing very fast cross-address space calls using this door mechanism. This protected procedure call is an illustration of how Nucleus makes sure that even though it has an object-based design and it is using object orientation in the building of the it is using object orientation in the structuring of the operating system kernel, it ensures that it will still be performant in the sense that you can do this cross-domain calls very quickly through this idea of deactivating the client thread and quickly activating the thread to execute the entry point procedure in the target domain, and on return, reactivating the client thread. And all of this results in very fast cross-address space calls through this door mechanism. That's how you make sure that you get all the good attributes of object orientation and not sacrifice on performance at the same time.